Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Sam's Disney Diary. I am here in Space 220 with creative executive Tom. And Tom, you've been here a long time at Walt Disney World in Imagineering.
Yes.
In fact, I did a little research. You have been here for over 40 years.
Yes.
And I know we're here to talk about Walt Disney World's 50th anniversary, but Epcot's 40th is next year, which means you've been here since the beginning of Epcot.
I have.
How has this Epcot transformation, this restaurant that we're sitting in, this has to be exciting times.
It's totally exciting. I mean, when we started the work on the transformation of Epcot, we were looking for ways to make it more family fun, more family friendly throughout, and also stay true to Epcot's DNA. And, you know, we have this great restaurant, Coral Reef,
sure,
where you get to dine undersea. And we were saying we really should find a signature dining experience on the other side of the park to balance it. I mean, everybody knows World Showcase is
sure,
a culinary centerpiece.
Absolutely.
Of Epcot, but why not in the front too? Why not elevate the dining experience? And so we said, well, with underwater here, why not outer space? And we had room next to Mission Space and said, all right, that's astronaut training and that's intense.
Sure.
But space tourism is evolving now. And how about something that really addresses...
Talk about timely.
Yeah, I mean, we started this in 2014. Who knew? Now it's really top of mind. But the idea of saying, hey, let's give guests an experience that in the future you could actually take a space elevator up to a station and have lunch or dinner or breakfast or, you know, and give guests a sense of what would it be like to look at our planet from space and enjoy and appreciate it from space while you're having a really fine dining experience.
So how much of that inspiration comes from the coral reef or the other side of the park? Because you sit and you watch the nature and world nature, right?
Right.
Now we're over World Discover. It's perfect because I love to walk, wait for Mickey to come by, and we'll look for Dory and the fish. And now what we're doing is looking for the astronauts,
exactly,
looking for the space station. You've really taken that experience and duplicated it in a unique way.
Yeah, and we've tried to, you know, basically once you're up the stellarvator, how you get up to Space 220, you know, is so much fun for guests. And it's also a bit of a throwback because for those who remember the old Flight to the Moon or Mission to Mars, the original one.
Sure.
You know, had a theater that had a screen below and a screen above, and you mm-hmm. saw the world disparate. And we said, why don't we do that but as a space elevator, which is something that scientists have talked about for our future, and let guests see Epcot receding away, and here goes the state, I can see the state of Florida, and here comes the space station up above, and really give you an immersive dining experience all the way. Come in, have your meal, and then take the elevator back to Epcot, and time of day appropriate, weather appropriate, to really make it as believable as possible, because this will be in the future. Hopefully in ours, but it will be in the future, and that's what we want to give guests a taste of, as well as a taste of a great meal.
There's so many things I want to ask you about what you just said, because you started with the name of the elevator, and immediately anybody that's been watching Disney or visiting for the 40 years that you've been around, we think Hydrolator. So it's fun throwback.
It's an immersive storytelling device that, you know, or you could think Haunted Mansion, you know, the stretching room, you know, getting people in the mood for their experience. Yes, you could walk in off the street and immediately be here, but you wouldn't believe that you had traveled space. So we're Imagineers. So it's like, well, I want you to believe we've taken to the, you know, the elevator experience. You feel the rumble. You see Epcot. You see the cars on test track. You see the boats in World Showcase Lagoon. It's a believable experience, and of course we're so fortunate to get to work with our colleagues at ILM, Industrial Light and Magic, you know, who've worked with us on so many projects to create this media for us to bring it to life, as well as all the things that take place outside the window. And our tone here was, look, this is a time when traveling to space is almost every day in a sense, right?
Sure.
I'm gonna go up for lunch and then go back to Earth. And so what goes on outside the window is more of, in a sense, in the background, right?
Yes.
Ships are coming and going occasionally because there are workers who are moving beams in, but it's space tourism. So you're going to see families walking a dog in space. You're going to see kids playing with toys in space. You're going to see, you know, a romantic couple taking a spacewalk. And so we really tried to make sure that we created images that are inclusive to say, I can picture myself, or my family, my kids, my partner, in that future, and how exciting will it be, which is what Epcot's all about, right? How exciting can the future be? with an optimistic view and with all of us working together.
This restaurant is amazing. It's a great addition, and I love the balance that it does bring to the front of Epcot and your World Discovery,
right.
World Nature, and World Celebration in the middle. And you mentioned before, the whole transformation of Epcot is bringing more characters. And we're seeing that with Remy. We saw that with Frozen. We saw that with even the 50th statues that are moving around. This 50th anniversary is huge. And you've been here for a lot of those 50 years.
And I worked, and when I was in college, I worked in the Magic Kingdom. So I have a lot of my history here. And I worked on the Skyway. It was my first ride when I worked at Walt Disney World back as a kid. And so I love that.
The Skyway shirt. That's a perfect match. So what can we expect? You know, the 50th is awesome. The plans have to be in works. Look. And you got this 18-month celebration, which is going to lead us right into the 100th year of the Walt Disney Company in 2023. Yeah. So that's obviously coming. You got Epcot 40 next year. So much more to come here.
That's right.
We appreciate it.
It never stops. I mean, that was Walt's goal, right?
Last night, watched the final Epcot Forever, and it starts with Epcot will always be in state of transformation.
Everything you see will change time again. But the message of Epcot, you know, this optimistic future that we can create together, is part of it. And so this restaurant, this is a science-based restaurant, you know, and the IP in this restaurant is real science. So this is going to happen one day, and that's our goal, is to excite people about what the future could be.
The timing is amazing, Tom, with everything happening in the world today. Thank you for getting us down that path, and thank you guys for watching.
You.
So much more coming from the 50th anniversary of Walt Disney World. Thanks, Tom.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching. So much more coming from Walt Disney World's 50th anniversary kickoff. Hit that subscribe button for more. We'll see you soon. Kongaloosh.